G2 wireless battery packs are finally here, and they're actually really good. Anker is the first to market with new G2 battery packs that can charge up to 15 watts for iPhone 13, 14, and 15. This new MagGo has an exterior screen that lets you know the percentage of the battery, plus how long it'll take to charge this battery and how much charge it has left. This USB-C port on the side offers 27 watts fast charging for your iPhone. It can even charge your iPad and other USB-C devices, and has a nice little kickstand so you can stand up your phone while it's charging. Now, G2 battery packs had a lot of promises over the original wireless battery packs like this one from Anker. These old ones charged at a slow 5-watt pace and they all got really hot. G2 solves all of that by charging much faster at 15 watts. It doesn't get as hot, I'll get to that in a second, but even this G2 battery pack, which was built on the MagSafe standard, I have a whole video explaining that, I'll put it above and in the description, still lacks some features that Apple's first party battery pack did, which they discontinued. I'll get into some of those differences and quirks with this G2 battery pack and tell you what other G2 batteries are coming very soon that you might want to wait for. So in the box, you get the new Anker MagGo G2 battery pack. It is a 10,000 milliamp hour battery pack, which is a lot more than what those older wireless packs were, and you do get a USB-C cable in the box. On the device itself, you have the magnetic ring and the alignment magnet, plus we get a new little G2 logo right here on the battery pack. On this side, there is a screen that actually shows you how long to charge this battery pack and how much charge it has left. I'll show you that in a second. And the USB-C port here on the side, mostly because you can use it as a stand using this on the back. This way you can still charge the battery pack and have your phone laying on it all at the same time. Now, when I posted a picture of this on social media, you guys immediately noticed, yes, this is a thick battery pack.
Boy, he's thick!
It's probably about double the thickness of an iPhone 15 Pro, but it is a 10,000 milliamp hour battery. Twice as much battery capacity as the older MagGo battery packs. This is a 5,000 milliamp hour. This is 10,000. Anker does have a couple different sizes available now, but other brands are also going to have 5, 10, and even 20,000 milliamp hour battery packs. So you should be able to get one thinner or thicker depending on your needs. Now, when you need to charge the battery pack, you can plug it in and charge up to 20 watt speeds right here. And the little screen on the side, once you plug it in, will tell you how long until this battery pack is full. This screen might be a little divisive, maybe you don't want that on the outside or it's an eyesore. You can always turn it off by pressing this button down on the battery pack. Turn it on to see the data, but I really like knowing how long until this is charged. And then once you connect it to a device, this time will update to let you know how many hours of charge the battery has left for the phone. I do find this is not as useful. It's not telling you what percentage it'll get to, but that will also vary on if you're still using your phone while it's charging on the battery pack. And yes, I did some testing, so I'll give you numbers in a moment, but I'm down for the side screen. I like it. Now, the G2 battery pack does offer pass-through charging. So if you want to plug in the battery pack to USB-C and still charge your phone, you can still do that. You'll see the phone is still charging and now the battery pack is charging as well. And you can see it's updating the time. Takes a few seconds for that to really get correct. Now, that is a one-way power. So if you want to charge the phone and battery, plug in the battery, it does not work reverse from this iPhone to the battery. That's unlike Apple's own MagSafe battery pack, which you could actually plug a lightning cable into this on the back of my iPhone 15 Pro and charge both the battery and the phone. That is one of the missing features between Apple's MagSafe battery pack and these new G2 battery packs. Also, for those of you who had Apple's MagSafe battery pack, yes, it's a lot thinner, had much less capacity, but when you attached it to the back of the phone, you would get the nice battery percentage right here in the battery widget. So you could see your phone battery percentage and what the battery pack was at. Plus, if you attached it while the phone was locked, you get that nice kind of animation letting you know, oh yeah, there's the battery pack. You can see the charge of the battery there and the phone. Now, while you don't get it in the battery widget, if you attach it while the phone is locked, you do get that nice little ring animation like the MagSafe battery pack. That's different from an older one. This is the Anker MagGo, just regular Qi 5-watt charger. And if I connect it, you'll see you get the little charging in the dynamic island, but you don't get that nice little ring animation. And while that ring animation is nice, I would really prefer to see the battery here in the widget on the iPhone, but you just do not get that option. See here, I added an even larger battery widget to my home screen and still no battery pack, even though the phone is charging. Also, the G2 battery pack can charge your AirPods wirelessly right here on the magnet as well. Now for the big question, is charging with G2 that much faster and that much better? In my testing, yes. I ran my phone down to 14% at 7 p.m. and then I attached this G2 battery pack, it was fully charged, and I continued using my phone. So it was pretty moderate usage. I was doing connections in Wordle, had the screen on a lot. And by 10:28, about 3 hours and 27 minutes later, it charged it 66%, from 14% to 80%. All my previous battery packs would not have gotten it up that much with continual use in that span of time. And the biggest difference between this G2 battery pack and the older, just regular Qi, was the heat. These older battery packs that were using just regular Qi wireless technology would get very hot. Like it would be uncomfortable to hold kind of hot. Now, compare that to Apple's MagSafe battery pack. This was one of the few that did not get hot while charging, but it charged glacially slow. And if you were using your phone a lot with this on it, it would basically hold it around the same percentage. It wouldn't actually raise or continue to charge the phone. But as you can see from this battery chart, when I attached this battery pack, and you can see my screen time usage down here, I was still using my phone pretty heavily. It went all the way up 66% from 7 o'clock to about 10:30. That's a pretty good charge cycle. As it was charging, it felt warm, but no warmer than just charging your iPhone on a regular MagSafe stand, like on your nightstand, or charging it on something like this, the Anker 3-in-1 Cube. It was about the expected warmness of wireless charging, and it wasn't uncomfortable to hold. Now, holding the phone with this size battery pack, that was a little uncomfortable and ungainly, but it stayed on the entire time. These magnets were plenty strong. Just to give you an idea, if it's attached to the back of the phone, it stayed on there okay. If I shake it hard enough, I mean, it's gonna fall off. Like that. And while it shouldn't affect the battery that much, I was actually charging through this Keyway leather case. You might get a little better charge without the case, having the battery directly on the phone, but this case has the MagSafe rings in it, so I don't think there's gonna be a ton of difference. Now the Qi2 battery pack still had some juice at 10:28 p.m., but you could see it had to put charging on hold at that point. This might be part of that advanced communication between the battery pack and the phone, but there was enough heat over the last 3 hours of it charging the phone and me using it where it did stop charging. So it likely with heavy usage, let's say you're at a conference, it won't get the phone back up to 100%, even though the battery pack has plenty of juice to do that. If getting your phone to 100% is important to you, then maybe you want to bring a USB-C cable and you can charge your phone from your battery using that physical cable, and that way you'll definitely get to 100% even on this battery. You can also see when it's plugged in over a cable, I can be charging for 3 hours. This battery pack is still 65% capacity left. It will definitely charge this phone to 100%. And even on Anker's box, it says that it will do 2 full charges of an iPhone 14 Pro. Of course, that's over the cable, not wirelessly. And to compare capacity of the battery packs, when the Apple MagSafe battery pack goes from 100 and goes all the way down to 0 charging the phone, I got 26% increase in battery percentage. Again, that's a 5000 milliamp hour battery and it charges much slower. And so that's 60% charge from the Qi2 battery pack until it got too hot to continue charging versus 26% on Apple's MagSafe battery pack. That's double the charge from the Qi2 battery pack even with continuous use. You can also charge things like an iPad mini or even iPad Pro. You see it charging right there, plugged directly into this Qi2 battery pack, but it won't charge something like an M3 Pro, MacBook Pro. It just doesn't have high enough output. Lastly, with Qi2, I thought we might get standby mode where it remembers the configuration depending on the device. So here it is on the Qi2 Anker charger. If I move it over to the Anker 3-in-1 Cube, change what the standby screen is, if it was really communicating via NFC, it should remember the configuration from the Qi2 battery pack. But you can see as I move it over, it doesn't remember the previous configuration. It just goes back to whatever I had on that other standby charger. So if you were in the market for a wireless battery pack for your iPhone, now is the time to get one. Qi2 definitely has that faster 15-watt charging. These battery packs do not get as hot as the others, and there's great features like this outside screen and fast charging your iPhone directly with that USB-C port. And iPhones all the way back to the iPhone 13 will get the benefits of Qi2 charging. iOS 17.2, when it came out, actually brought support for Qi2, that 15-watt charging, back to the iPhone 14 and 13. So you can take advantage of this too. If you're wondering how that's possible, it is because the Qi2 standard is literally built on Apple's MagSafe. I explained that in my last video if you're interested. Again, that link's down in the description. But faster charging, less heat, Qi2 is the way to go if you want a wireless battery pack. Now, Qi2 battery packs are not going to be inexpensive. This 10,000 milliamp hour battery pack from Anker is $90. If you remember, Apple's MagSafe battery pack was $99. But you do get higher capacity, and this is the newer Qi2 standard. Anker does sell a 6,500 milliamp hour battery pack. This is $70, but this is also just as thick because they kind of have it separated between the stand and the battery pack. I prefer more milliamp hours for this kind of thickness, but this is another option you have. Now, Anker was the first to market, but other brands including Mophie and Belkin have announced that Qi2 battery packs are coming soon. As you watch this video, the availability isn't until March, so we're still about a month and a half to a couple months away, but you'll have more size options. Belkin is gonna have a 5, 10, and 20,000 milliamp hour battery pack, but they'll still be in this price range from $80 to $100. Overall, I'm really happy with this. I like the kickstand, the screen, it has great capacity, and if I don't wanna have to carry any cables and still be able to charge my iPhone on the go, Qi2 is the way to go. So if you have any questions, leave them down in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel. As more Qi2 power banks come out from Belkin, Mophie, and others, I'll be reviewing them right here on the channel. So hit that like button. And if you want to see that video where I talk about Qi2 versus MagSafe, I'll put that video right up here. And if you want to learn about some settings that will help you save some battery life, I have 27 settings that actually matter on the iPhone. I'll put that video right up here. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you in the next video.